resident of Maharashtra contributes 32,000 rupees a year as taxes to the center. The average resident of Gujarat, Tamil Nadu and Karnataka contribute roughly around 20,000 rupees to the center. But on the other hand, the average resident of Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Bihar and West Bengal contribute a mere 6,000 rupees as taxes to the center every year. Once these taxes are sent to the center keeps 58% for itself and divides the remaining 42% across all the states. So how much does each state get back from the center as its share of tax revenues? For every 100 rupees in taxes that the average Maharashtrian sends to the center, only 15 rupees comes back to the state of Maharashtra, and the 85 rupees is kept to fund the center and other states. So in the Tamil Nadu example, for every 100 rupees that the average Tamilian sends to the center, 34 rupees comes back to the state of Tamil Nadu, whereas 66 rupees is used to fund programs in other states, such as the UP farm loan waiver. So for every 100 rupees that the average resident of UP sends to the center, he gets back 200 rupees for his state, and the average Bihari gets 400 rupees back. So clearly, the Maharashtrian, Gujarati, Tamilian and the Karnataka are bearing almost all of the costs of nation building. In this context, how would a Tamilian farmer who's pleading for his farm loan waiver feel when he realizes that his state is helping pay for UP's farm loan waiver? This is the big question confronting India's political economy today.